Today I'm going to show you how to use custom environments in SketchUp to get looks like this. Hey there, it's Matt here, and environments were introduced in SketchUp 2025 to provide image-based lighting for PBR, physically based rendered materials. So there are some kind of unique looks that weren't accessible to SketchUp visualizations before, but now you can use environments in a couple different ways to create some, I think, really cool looking models. And so I'm going to walk through a couple of them with you here today. So let's jump into it. So in case you're not familiar, if you go over to the environments panel and go to the environments drop down here, you can test out a couple of pre-made environments for your model that ship with SketchUp, and these can also be found on the 3D warehouse. So you can see the look and the color of the materials changes as I change to the different environments here. But what if we want something a little bit different than that? So I'll show a couple different ways to do that. One is if you go to the site called Polyhaven. This is a free asset library. And under assets here, if we go to HDRIs, so SketchUp can import EXR and HDR skydome high dynamic range images to use for image-based lighting. And here is a collection of a lot of those. So I just want, like, let me try to pick a cool one here. We want this building in the desert, in the Rosendahl Plains. You can select, they have different 20K, holy cow. They have different resolutions in here. I'll just do 2K for this one, and then you can choose HDR or EXR. Both of these will work within SketchUp, but I'll give this a download here. And then back in SketchUp, I can hit this plus button on the, here, I'll bring this over here, right to the middle. This plus button imports an environment. So I will do that. Select my my environment that I downloaded here, and it'll instantly populate. So I can see that maybe if I'm using this as a background, I want a little bit higher resolution, but I like the colors that it's giving. And once I get this in, one thing that's important to do to make the reflections look as if they're realistic with the shadows is to use this set sun location checkbox. So when I hit set sun location, it gives me this sun on the thing here. And you can see as I move this around, the shadows update. I'm going to place it right on the sun, ironically, set sun location. And now all the reflections that are showing up in my model are reflecting the accurate sun location that will also show up for these shadows. So that's one thing to note if you are bringing in custom skydomes, is you can set the sun location to so your shadows match the reflections. And I'm not going to go into everything that environments offer, but you can also, if it's a little dark or light, you can, you know, change with this slider. It's a sunny day, so maybe it's very bright outside. Put on your shades for this one, folks. Another way that I found to be useful is maybe, you know, Polyhaven or some of these other sites with HDRs don't have the exact look that I'm looking for. Like, I want this kind of very clean, clean edges. And even if I use one of the studio backdrops, it's not giving me the exact look that I'm looking for here. So one thing that I found useful was going to stock image websites. So this environment you can see is like a kind of a simple look here, but I wanted a simple look. So this is from Adobe Stock, as you can see here. And I'll show you the process. I'll just go ahead and delete this. You can see if I do pick from one of the pre-made environments, even if I turn off the skydome, it's kind of not the clean, you know, look that I was going for. So I'll just turn these off and actually purge unused as well and show you how I did that in the stock. So you can use the stock service of your choice or the image search of your choice. So in here, I'll search HDR studio background. And the first result is a tiger. Okay, well, probably not that one, but like something like this. So the idea of an HDR is it's a full like skydome, that's what it's called in SketchUp, around your model, right? So it kind of looks bendy and weird when you look at it on here, but when you get it into the spherical, let's actually turn off generative AI images so we can get some ones that are a little more intentionally made. Maybe let's try this one. So I'll just go ahead and download this. And it downloads as a JPEG, which if you remember, is not an EXR or HDR file. So that will not be able to be imported in SketchUp. But I'm gonna open this in Photoshop and show you how to convert it to a file that can be used in SketchUp. So first thing is, look, this wasn't originally, I mean, I guess it was created for an HDR, but it's not as high dynamic range as you would typically get from an HDR image. But I'm just looking for the general lighting. The actual values of the photo don't really matter too much to me. So one thing that I have to do, I'm converting this JPEG. You can see it's 8-bit here. You can use any photo editing software for this, but this is an 8-bit file. HDR files are higher bit than that. So we're going to change the mode to 32 bits per channel. The other thing you want to check too is that it's not in grayscale. Even though this image is in grayscale, it has to be an RGB color in order to export as an HDR. So save as and EXR, that's the one we're looking for. And save it. It'll come up with this compression and I'll talk a little bit more about this later. Let's give this a shot and see what the file size is. Okay, 256 megabytes. Obviously, this original JPEG that I got was 1.6 megabytes. This is just extra information that's not adding anything because it's not actually there. So I'm actually going to save this with a different type of compression. So I'll pop in here and save it with, I don't know, Zlib. I know nothing about this, but let's check it out and see if it's a more manageable file size. For reference, most of the environment files that ship with SketchUp are between like 4 and 10 megabytes. Large files for images, but not necessarily large for, you know, they're more optimized as far as HDRs go. And this one's 9 megabytes. That's gonna be good, not gonna slow down our model. So then I'll pop back over to SketchUp and same thing as before, import the environment. Not the 200 megabyte one, but the more manageable one. And you can see this is 8K. So this is a pretty high resolution file. Not that it really would make too much of a difference. This could be a 2K file and it would give us essentially the same look. One thing to notice, probably don't want to use this as a skydome because it doesn't really look good. Although it was made to look like an HDR, it's, you can see it's not really seamlessly tiling and it's kind of messy back there. So I'll go into edit and I'll just turn environment for skydome off. And now I'm just left with my model and my background, and I'm going to change the rotation angle until it's something that I like. I also want to bring that exposure, reflections up. I want a little more clean looking image here. And there we go. That's how you get any stock image or any image from a JPEG or a non-compatible file with the skydomes in SketchUp and bring it in as an environment. If you've seen anything thus far that you think is interesting or cool, hey, drop us a like down below. It doesn't cost anything. Oh, and I should mention too that the phone, I just did this kind of for fun to see what a little phone teaser product thing would look like. And if I turn, So you can see here that this is a relatively simple model. I'll turn on hidden geometry. And really the environment's doing all the heavy lifting for what you saw in the scene animation. So I'm using that same, I'll go back to this, using that same environment as I was in the other one, or not the one that I showed you, but the one that I had in previously. This is just a black background and fog, and then, you know, just kind of editing this to get the look that I like. You can see the clean background really shows up really well on just like a simple texture, giving a little hint of mystery, and then just animating that that rotation angle between scenes to get the, you know, the image-based lighting to move as the camera moves. So pretty simple, but I thought it looked cool. And the sort of modern day monolith that rules all of our lives. Okay, and the last one I want to show is creating your own environment. So I made a short on this a while ago. This environment here is one that I went out and made with my iPad. So you can see it's relatively high resolution. I wanted to, you know, put this model in here, very simplistic model, but to kind of visualize what it would look like. And I will put on the screen the app that I use to make this. There's a lot of different ways to use there's a lot of different ways to make your own HDRs. This is the simplest one that I found. This is a paid app, or at least you have to pay to download the HDRs. It's called HDRIEYE. And you basically just go to the spot that you want to make the environment. You hover over these little dots, and then it'll take multiple exposures at each of those. You go around in a circle, and it'll stitch together all those images and spit out a EXR that you can download. That's nice if you have a specific location that you want to create an environment for. I'll talk about the caveats in a second. But when I did download this file, and this is, you know, probably a common thing if you create your own, it's a very large file, which again, you know, you could bring into SketchUp, but it also might slow down, especially if you have a lot of complex geometry in there. So what I did is open it up in Photoshop again, use the photo editor of your choice. It was a cloudy day and it's kind of a dark image. One thing I would recommend is, you know, HDRs to me really look the best when there's a lot of high dynamic range, get it, on the day. So if I could have chosen the day, I would have gone back on a nicer day when it was more sunny, you know, maybe some variance in the clouds in the sky. This is kind of very gray and blah. So first of all, what I'm going to do is just add a little adjustment here to make it a little brighter. And then same thing, I'm going to save this as, and it's already an EXR, but I will use the compression to get it small enough. Hey, let's try a different one. RLE, whatever that means. Still 96, okay. Try a different one. Let's go to Zlib, my standby favorite. One thing too, you can see that this file is like 6K, 7K. So I could also change this to a smaller resolution if I needed to reduce file size significantly more. 68, so I think that's a relatively around the same size that I used for the actual one in here. But here, I'll delete this and add it back in to show the full process. Because one thing that I was like super stoked about when I first did this was, oh great, it's gonna look like I'm right, you know, at the, in the spot. Like I'm taking an environment from this exact spot. But the thing is, environments are, you know, background. So they're like infinitely far away. Any kind of perspective you have in your model is not really going to line up exactly right. And, you know, you can try to mess with the, how much, what, like what your zoom is, what your focal length is. but it's not really going to line up. One thing I did want to line up though was the alignment. So what I did was use this kind of grid on the ground. You can see it diverges, so it's not going to be exactly right. But just to line it up with this Calder statue in the background, I was like, okay, that's close enough. I mean, you could geolocate this, find out where north is, and then rotate this to exactly match that if you wanted like an, you know, exact reflections of your environment or something like that. But yeah, just keep in mind that it's not like easy context where you can just, okay, now this looks 100% perfect. That was my experience of creating this. Let's bring up that skydome exposure. Try to fake it that this was a little bit brighter day than it actually was. So who knows? Yeah, a couple different ways. I will say personally, I like this, just this clean look with, you know, the custom stock environment. There you go. So a couple different ways to get, you know, custom environments that are not part of the 18 environments that come packed in with SketchUp. I'm interested to see what kind of stuff you guys will create with custom environments. Have you made your own SkyDome? Have you made your own HDR? Do you have a, you know, a better way of creating those than I did? Or have you found any kind of clever tricks using environments to get a specific look? Let me know in the comments. And if you're watching this far in the video, come on, give me a like too. We appreciate the likes and the comments because it lets us know that we're making videos that you guys are liking, and that's the whole point. So yes, I appreciate you watching, and let us know if you have any ideas for future videos. And hey, take it easy. Have a great day.